that we had a look at was 2x plus 3y is equals to 5, right? So this is the linear equation that we understood, right? We solved for the solution of this linear equation. Now, what we need to understand is how we represent a linear equation which is in two variables on a graph, right? Or in geometrical form. So let's bring out a graph here and let's put this linear equation onto the graph. So now, in this graph, we can clearly see that the linear equation that we had was a linear equation in two variables, right? X and Y. And that linear equation gets transformed onto a straight line when we bring it into the geometrical form, right? So this is how we represent a linear equation in two variables.
Similarly, if we look at the triangle ADE, we can find the base again, which is AD. So from the bigger triangle, we can find the distance AD, and from the smaller triangle, we can find the distance AB. So by subtracting AB from AD, we can get the distance BD. So we can solve this. Now, in first triangle ABC, we can apply the trigonometric ratios and get the value of AB. So we can apply TOA here, since we have given opposite and we have to find adjacent. So tan is opposite upon adjacent. So we can apply tan of 60 degrees is equals to opposite is BC and adjacent is AB. So just put the values here. Tan 60 is root 3 is equals to BC length is 86.6 meters and AB we have to calculate. So just cross multiply and get the value of AB. AB will be equals to 86.6 upon root 3 meters. Similarly, we can apply TOA in triangle ADE and get the length this AD.
So let's conduct an experiment to find out what are the changes which goes in the chemical reactions. So let's perform the first simple experiment, which is burning of magnesium strip. Now I have a magnesium strip in my hand, which we are going to use in this activity. So let's begin with the activity. For this experiment, we need a forceps, a watch glass, a spirit lamp, and a magnesium strip. I will hold this magnesium strip with the help of this forceps, and now I will burn it over the burner. I have put a watch glass below. I have to be cautious while carrying out this experiment by keeping my eyes as far as possible. We can observe that magnesium ribbon burns with a dazzling white flame, and what remains at last is a white powder in a watch glass, which is nothing but magnesium oxide. This burning of magnesium strip is actually a chemical change from magnesium to magnesium oxide.
Now let us dive into some of the basic terminology that is associated with the study of light, and let's understand what these terms mean technically. So in our last lecture, we have seen that for us to be able to see the objects which are all around us, light reflected from these objects should reach our eyes. But then where does this light originate from? What is the origin from where this light comes? Well, we all know that in daytime, we are able to see all the objects which are around us with the help of the light of sun. And at night time, we use electrical appliances like bulbs and tube lights to help us see all the objects which are around us. Now, these are what are called as sources of light. So all the objects or things which provide us with light energy are what are called as the sources of light.